Hello. Welcome to the Arkham Lost and Found. Is there anything I can help you with? Just browsing? Okay. Anything piques your interest? Everything? Yeah. Me too. That's why I am in the business of acquiring all of these various antiques and vintage finds. Are you looking to just pick something up for your personal collection? Maybe repurpose something? Anything along those lines? No, just looking. Okay. Well, I am the sole proprietor, and the Arkham Lost and Found has been right here in the heart of Arkham for well over 100 years now, passed down through the generations, and has been here on Garrison Street for a little over 60, 65 years now. And everything you see has either been picked up, found, brought here, either through local residents, purchased at estate sale, by either myself or my father, his father before him. And either some things from local residents, even neighboring states, Rhode Island, Maine, and of course, right across the bridge over into revitalized Innsmouth. Have you been there yet? It's amazing how that town has started to flourish, especially given its, some might say, dark past. But, is there anything at all that I can show you? Okay. Well, you seem to be looking over in that direction quite frequently. So why don't we start there? You can see we have quite a few military items. Medical backpack, for less of a better word, latrine shovel, some other packs, and one notable item I'll show you right now. Is this military gas mask that of course we have underneath here. You can see it is the mask itself right here, the rubber mask, and then this, I guess it might be a bio suit, something like that. I'm no expert. Like I said, I don't make it my business to learn about all the items or their history, unless in the case of these and a couple other things, there's some strange circumstances and how we or I come into their possession. But this is a United States military gas mask. It has these plastic goggles, I guess, eye shields, breathing hose, I believe. No filters. There's one missing here. So this is definitely somewhat discounted, of course, but still a vintage item. Now, as I was saying, there was a young gentleman came in here, so the story goes. It's before my time. You familiar with the house up on Benefit Street? You can't really miss it. It's a little bit of an eyesore. It used to be known as the Shunned House. Very strange things used to go on there. Residents that lived there never stayed long, but one particular instance, there was a younger gentleman who went there and lived there, went to investigate with his uncle or something like this, and thought the place was haunted and such, and just put this down here for you. A second. Let me get the other item that goes with this story. This old vintage pickaxe. So as the story goes, you can see it has a wooden handle. Someone wrapped some electrical tape around here. It's a little loose here, so it's definitely needs a little work. So again, this is can give you a fair price on this if you're interested. But so as the story goes, this young gentleman and his uncle, family member, stayed in the house, and the young gentleman fell asleep, woke up to see his uncle transformed into some hideous creature. And so the next day he purchased a gas mask and some explosives or something, and this pickaxe, and went to go dig into the basement of the house and see what he could find. And apparently he came in here a day later or so, raving to my father how he, of untold horrors and things of this nature, and he wanted to get rid of this equipment, and of course the gas mask as well, as soon as possible. I don't even know if my father had to pay him anything. I can't recall, but in any case, it's the so-called story. Not everything you see behind me here has much of a story. A few things, though, and perhaps I'll go over those with you first. And let me see, what time is it? Less than an hour, we're going to be closing. If you need to go digging, whether it's an old house or, you know, digging up bodies in a cemetery. Just kidding. Well, this might be a thing for you. So, let me just put this down, okay? Just give me a moment, please. So I'll just go through and give you an overview. I guess I probably should have done that in the first place. So everything you see here is for sale, except for the wooden framework that keeps my small little shop from collapsing in on itself. But the crates, the boxes, everything inside, even that crate, an orchard crate, that box, anything you see. But starting up here to your left, we have an old little box there, some shelves. It's got two antique bottles in it. Another box next to that with some other antique bottles as well, medicine apothecary bottles. I'll show them to you here. Got this one here. Can see how aged it is. The cork is quite I'm not sure if it's burnt or molded, just from aged from time. But this is a very interesting has a little herbal scent to it. I'm not sure if there was medicinal herbs stored in here. You'll have to forgive me, I do quite enjoy just the sound textures of various objects. But yeah, so we have this. Some old medical books. Next to the books, you can see a variety of candlestick holders. Even have, I'm not sure if they call this a, I was going to say snuffer, but this is what you use to put the flame out, so you don't have to, you know, use your fingers or blow it out. You can see right inside there. Most of these. There's even an old hurricane lamp. Most of those candlestick holders, if not all of them, acquired from the kind folks over at the Esoteric Order of Dagon. Esoteric, I'm not sure how to pronounce that, but if you ever are interested in checking, they're over in Innsmouth, right down the heart, downtown Innsmouth. But it's a very interesting little candle holder. It's missing its glass top. You can see some pegs here, but nice little design with a little key, or you could hold it if you wanted to. This is, again, everything here is reasonably priced. Even though we are an antique shop, technically, you know, times are a little tough, and Arkham, you know, isn't what it used to be. Even though it's still, you know, thriving and busy, it's just, you know, middle class. So we're not looking to really gouge anyone with our prices. There's that hurricane lamp. This is a beautiful piece. It doesn't have a wick, so you would, if you're interested in purchasing this, you would need to purchase the wick yourself. But it, this is the, where the oil would go. And you would remove the chimney, the glass chimney, there. Has some little ridges, little design right up there on the top. No story behind this, like I said, just interesting piece. I will admit, sometimes my own curiosity and interest get the better part of me, and I also often pick up pieces that I find. Pique my own interest. Lots of abandoned houses here in Arkham. Lots of folks just disappear, sometimes without a trace. Police are always baffled, of course. They probably just end up moving behind, losing a job. Who really knows? Always strange reports, though, of all weird sightings, creatures, and things like this. Let me just put this back up a moment. Yes, that is a license plate from Pennsylvania, 1924. I've never been there myself, but not sure how my father got a hold of this. I'm assuming probably found on an abandoned car. Someone must have come up here to visit Arkham. Not really sure why. This isn't the most touristy town, but maybe they were visiting a relative and something happened and abandoned their car. Who knows? So many strange things and untold stories. I'm sure it happens in every small town throughout the United States. Some old typewriters, of course. I'll show you one of those just a moment. This is in Olivetti, Underwood, Littera 32. It still works. Probably just needs a new ribbon, but can see it was kept in good condition, good shape. Not really sure of the story behind this, but I believe it belonged to a famous writer. Used to write about all the strange goings on here in Arkham and neighboring Innsmouth. So like I said, it has some old ribbon in it, so you might need to replace that, but everything else works. It has been tested. I put a piece of paper in there myself and typed on it. And as I said, the ribbon is a little old, so the lettering was a little faded. What's interesting about this, now that I recall it, I went to test it. Went about my day, I left it over in the workshop where we bring a lot of the new items in and check them out and all that. And I was just typing, I forget what it was, but it's interesting. I came back and there's actually a lot of strange characters typed on the paper. Don't really know what happened. I'm assuming that my wife or one of the other workers here probably switched the paper or typed or drew something just to kind of freak me out a little bit, but I don't know. You never know, maybe there's something more to this typewriter, right? Let me just put this back. So I showed you the gas mask, of course. It's an interesting piece. It is a medic's backpack, for lack of a better word. Little medic insignia there. It's canvas. It is in very good shape. Open it up and you have the main area here, compartment. And then there's this other little area right here. Don't ask me what a military medic would carry in here besides necessary tools, of course, and equipment. But none of which we have. And it has some little straps over here, you can see. Another little compartment right there. A pocket, lots of pockets. There's a drawstring right here. Another pocket over here, the belt enclosure. So there, it's so it's a nice piece. So I'm not sure if that's something that strikes your fancy or not. is the military latrine shovel, from what I understand. Now, I'm not really too sure how many latrines it's seen in its lifetime, but I don't want to know. But it's been, besides from the rust, it's been cleaned off and has been in use now for decades. There's this old wooden handle here. Quite rusted though. So, again, I'm not sure if that's something that interests you. Another U.S. military pouch of some kind. I'm not sure what it says. There is a date here, November 29th, I believe 1965, if I'm not mistaken. There was a CP right here. It looks like a crown symbol. So a little pocket here. This is canvas. It has a little belt type clasp right here to close it. And a little, some straps to, I guess, over your shoulder or perhaps around the waist. Like I said, I've never been in the military and don't know the ins and outs of every little item here, but it's not really my business too. It's my job just to try to find some unique things, various real estate, or not real estate, estate sales, things that have been abandoned on the side of the road. An abandoned house, but by the way, I'm just curious what brings you here to Arkham? Traveling alone? Okay, yeah. Here is the military gas mask. You see, mask, chemical, biological, field, M17 series, U.S. R-R-R-O-R-R-B-R. I'm not really sure. So this is something down here. No. There's a small little pocket down the very bottom there. Another canvas. Straps that I believe would go around the waist, perhaps over the shoulder too. So this would is where you would carry the gas mask. The young gentleman that I told you about acquired. So this is, again, fairly reasonably priced if you're interested in something like this. That course, there's an old box here. I'll show you that. Not really sure what it used to contain. Is that a nice, pleasing sound? I swear I feel like one of the reasons I clicked all these things is not just because of the nostalgia, but just the tactile response, the feel. Anyway, it's a little label here, keep away from fire. Now it's just taped on here. I don't really know if it's been on there the entire time or if this was just added here later. Keep away from fire, heat, and open flame lights. Caution, leaking packages must be removed to a safe place. Do not drop. This is to certify that the contents of this package are properly described by name and are packed and marked and are in proper condition for transportation according to the regulations prescribed by the Interstate Commerce Commission. Shipper's name required here. Here on for shipments by express. So, but it's a nice box. And you could use it as a planter, I'm sure, if you sealed it up nicely, or just for storage or decoration. Repurpose it, I'm sure. So. A moment. Put this back the way I had it. Okay. Well, that's going to do it for most of everything on that side. And work our way over here. Another interesting little story about a piece here. Let me get to that and get to these cameras. This beautiful vintage hard shell suitcase. I believe the name of the company that manufactured it, it says Mandel Cincinnati, MAS. It doesn't necessarily mean that's where it was found, like I said, but this belonged to a gentleman by the name of, what was it again, Randolph Carter. Another interesting story. Young gentleman who was unfortunately suffered from some severe mental illness. And was stayed up at the wonderful Arkham Sanitarium right down the street. And now this was before it burned down. But as the story goes, he escaped from Arkham Sanitarium and showed up with a suitcase. Also have a picture of him as well. I'll show you in just a moment. And arrived at his family's doorstep. raving mad about how he was able to bring back one of his relatives, old relatives from the dead, or something like this. I tell you, you live here long enough in Arkham, and you will hear many a story, many a strange tale. You know how these stories go from one generation to the next. Apparently, the Randolph Carter, the relative that he brought back from the dead, with ashes or something, from some crypt, I believe, killed Randolph and then took over his identity or something like this. The family doctor, Dr. Whipple? Something like that? Whittle, maybe? Ended up investigating. But this suitcase is the suitcase of Randolph Carter. No, I'm sorry. It's not Randolph Carter. It's Charles Ward. Randolph Carter. I'm getting, you know, it's been so long. You hear so many tales. I think this is the suitcase of Charles Dexter Ward. I think that's his name. That was his name. So, let me open this up for you. You can see it's beautiful. Little dusty inside, but given the circumstances, one would expect that. Beautiful fabric pouches here. Store whatever one might have used to store in a suitcase like this back in the early 1900s, 20th century. And some more pouches right down here, and on the sides as well here. They're lined with fabric, and even these old fabric straps to, I assume, to tie down your clothes or whatnot. So yes, if this is again something that piques your interest and you might be interested in adding to your collection, you know, again, it's a fair price. Let's put this back here. And speaking of a picture of, Charles Dexter Ward, I believe it is. Few pictures here. Don't really know who some of these folks are, but it's a young gentleman. I'm not really sure where this is from. There's nothing really written on the backs. But somebody's son, somebody's father, perhaps. Interesting. I find these old photographs from a bygone era so evocative of emotion and story. It makes you wonder whatever became of them, who they were. Whatever, whoever, wherever. Ah, yes. The gentleman that owned the suitcase, Charles Dexter Ward. or Randolph Carter. You can check me on that when you leave here. But seems like a very distinguished, intelligent gentleman. Interesting attire. Little brooch there. Looks like some kind of silk shirt. Not really sure. Definitely distinguished though. Interesting how they dressed back then. Almost 100 years ago. Again, not really sure who this person is. You can see fairly dressed up nicely. Someone's mother, perhaps. Never know. A dignitary of sorts, perhaps. Politician. Politician's wife. And then another little spot there. A little speck of something. Another young person, young woman, again dressed up nice, perhaps in college. Maybe they all got dressed up just for the whatever the purpose of these photos was. Again, not really sure who she was, or whatever became of her. As it is for many folks here in Arkham. Just give me one moment, please. You have to forgive me. It's getting late. Washing board in the back there. Let me just show you this first. This is an old medical bag. A little bit of a hard shell, but not quite like the suitcase. It's these old handles. I don't think it's leather, some kind of canvas. You can see it's this black is peeling away, reveals a fibrous material underneath. Sure if it's cowhide, handles maybe. Open this up for you. Nothing inside really. Pretty fairly ordinary as far as the inside of a bag would go. One little compartment. Some little straps in the bottom connected to the side of the wall here, perhaps for holding vials, maybe. But apparently, obviously, belonged to a doctor who I can't say. There's no name affiliated with it. But this was here since I became the proprietor. Apparently, medical bags like this are a thing of the past, and no one really has much interest in them. Let me get that water. washboard. This is actually glass. It's about, looks like, almost a half inch thick. It says National Something Company, number 512, trademarks, it's faded. Saginaw. Don't really know what else it says there. On the back here, nothing really noteworthy. There's again, it says National all the way down. Very hard, thick glass. Just imagine what this might have been used for in the past. Very interesting, that's for sure. A little dusty, a little dirty, but not really going to be able to bring this back to life. It's faded and it has seen its days, that's for sure. But always an interesting little addition. To, you know, maybe your kitchen or your laundry area, sitting area, whatever. Nice little conversation piece. Let me get that back. Some very old vintage. Medical instrument cases. This one says Germany, so I'm assuming that's where it was made. Seems like it might be like vinyl material. But, little straps to hold different instruments, and has this fabric in here. It's almost like felt, but not quite. Or maybe it was, but it's worn out now. So I have a couple of these if you're interested in those. This other one. It's quite old. It's vinyl. Plastic material inside here. You can see. Another very hard vinyl. On the outside. Again, don't really know who owned this. It says split cowhide. Not really sure what that means, but again, a nice little piece. If you're sure you can find some use for it, find it interesting. This other case, I believe it may be cowhide as well, but inside do have a few instruments. little scissors. Made in Germany. So I believe they may have go with that other case that I showed you earlier, the brown one. It's that little dental mirror. So, doesn't really show who might have made that, or... Another pair of... Well, I don't want to say scissors, forceps, or clamps. Miller's Forge, 563 USA. These have little teeth. I believe these may be clamps or forceps, but I'm no expert. So each one of these instruments is priced separately. The case is made out of cowhide, it says here in the middle, in the inside, genuine cowhide. Other little instrument here has a very sharp, almost like an arrowhead, thin. I'm not sure if it's like a scalpel or some. I believe you twist this off and there's more little inserts inside that you can exchange out. So that's it for the little medical instruments there. I have this vintage camera, as you can see. It also has a hard shell case. Number 1A Kodak Junior, Eastman Kodak Company. Made by Eastman Kodak Company, Rochester, New York, USA. Doesn't really say much of a date, but I would date this somewhere in the early 1900s, 1920s, 1930s. So you would look right down here in this glass. Here's the bellows. The film would go in the back here. You would load big cartridge of film there, I believe. And this, the bellows, you can see, slides out like that. And you would look down here, right out through the lens. Well, the lens is here. I guess this would be the, I'm no photographer, but anyway, you would look through there to line up your shot. Here's the lens. The lens says rapid rectilinear Bausch & Lomb Optical Company. So a Bausch & Lomb lens. And it has here the, I believe that's the stops. 4, 8, 16, 32, 64. Up here it says 25, 50, 100. I believe that may be the speed. And then you take that picture with that little lever right there. Beautiful piece. I'm not sure if you're interested in something like this to collect or maybe just have around your home. Do you live, that's right, I asked if you, I'm not sure if you're just passing through. Yeah, okay. interesting piece, though. And of course, it folds right up. I would fold this up for you, but it's very noisy. Here is the case. Surprising. Looks like felt inside. Carrying case for Cinekodak 8, made in USA by Eastman Kodak Company, Rochester, New York. Some kind of cowhide, perhaps. Not really sure. Got a little strap right here. Little clasp closure there. And you would just... a little felt. Almost like a felt material in there. But... no, it's actually... you know, maybe at the bottom. Yeah, down the bottom is very soft. So I guess when you drop the camera in there, a little protection for it. So that's that. Also have this other vintage. This is actually a... oh, I'm sorry. Silly me. The case is for this. I told you I'm no photographer. The camera, the still camera, folds up into itself. So it has its own case. This is the case for this. This is a movie camera. Or it was. Well, it still is, but it doesn't work. And you would look through here, line up your shot. You could focus right here. F2.7, 13 millimeters, Kodak anastigmat. Then we have F2.7, 3.5, 5.6, 8, 11, 16. Cinekodak 8, model 25. Made in USA by Eastman Kodak Company, Rochester, New York. So you would open this up here. I'll show you this. So you can see you would get the film in one of these little boxes here. And you would load the film here. And I guess you would wrap it around and it would spool. It would, as you filmed, it would spool around here. So, you record, or you capture your film by winding up the spring. Here, you can hear it. This is a little noisy, but there's a spring inside here. It's going to turn this. And, I believe you push this down. No, let's see, where do you... how do you film again with this? I thought it was with that, but I guess it's not. Well, oh yes, it is with that. You have to push it back. You push it down. See? So, and then, it's, spring-loaded, so I'm not really sure how well this would film when it would slow down. So, how would that affect the images that you're capturing? But again, this is another little interesting little sorry, getting a little mesmerized there by the sounds of that. Nice little vintage item. It's getting late, getting ready to close, but I'll show you just a few more things here. Old canteen, nothing really to show you there. You definitely don't want to drink out of that. Some old something in the very back I want to show you at the end here before we leave. Pestle and mortar, some old drinking. Silverware, or maybe just silver plated. Sure, if that's something you're interested in. Some old silverware. Tudor plate. Oneida community. See, just some old silverware here. Nothing, too fancy here. Rogers and Brothers reinforced plate. So, fairly inexpensive. Just imagine who might have used these. Could have just been your average person, or maybe one of the aristocrats. Who knows? Some tools over here to show you. This scythe, very interesting piece. This was found on the grounds of Arkham Sanitarium after it was burnt down, of course, during the fire, before the new facility, state-of-the-art facility, opened up, of course. There will always be a mystery on what happened to the original Arkham Sanitarium and all the tragic lives that were that died in that fire. But in any case, this is very vintage piece. It's got a big old bolt right through the wood handle here. So it's sturdy, a little loose. But it's not gonna fall apart like that pickaxe might. Very nice wooden handle, of course. Down here is, you have the handles themselves. Where you would hold to swing the scythe back and forth to reap your crops, I suppose. Not really sure. Never used one myself, but interesting piece. And we have, you can see some very large axes in the back there. Double-headed axe and another single blade, double-bladed, however, whatever the appropriate term is, and a single blade axe. See if I can get that for you. Let's just move this a little bit. Beautiful axe. Blade seems to be sharp. Can hear how tempered that steel. I'm not really sure what an axe blade is made out of. Something closely resembled to steel, I'm sure. Not anything like copper is what I mean, but you can see the edges of the axe are fairly chipped, so it's seen its days, I'm sure. Nice wooden handle, too. Can only imagine what this axe might have been used for. Or who might have used it. No personal history, or I should say no history behind it. But there's always one. Just a matter of uncovering the story. All of these items have a story from the I guess you could say from the everyday and banal existence of one's life to perhaps something more horrific or something tragic. Or something, you know, exciting and noteworthy. But so there you have that. Again, it's decently priced if you're interested. I'm just gonna put this back here for now. Nothing else really to show you. Just have this old, looks like a chisel. Sure what else you would call it. Very interesting piece. Some kind of text written on it, but I can't really make it out. Looks like it says plume. P-L-U-M-E. But nice wooden handle. You know, if you're ever interested, you could always go down to the Arkham Historical Society. Maybe take one of these with you. And they might be able to, might be difficult, but you might be able to track something down about it or the owner. You never know. Well, I think that's going to do it. It's getting very late, and I'm going to have to close up shop. But before you go, I want to show you one last thing. It's something I've been wanting to show you ever since you showed up, but I like to save the best for last. It's this little interesting, I guess you might say, an effigy. It is the property of Miskatonic University. Well, it was the property until it came into my possession. I want you to take a nice, long, close, up close look. This.